white sandwich bread. So using this bread, you can make simply a toast or stuff with some vegetables and make a delicious sandwich recipes. So I have already shared some sandwich recipes like carrot sandwich and a potato sandwich. Kindly have a look, and if you want to know how to make sandwich, so let me show you what are the ingredients you need to make this. So to begin with, in a mixing bowl, take 2 cups of all-purpose flour, 1 teaspoon of active dry yeast, 1 teaspoon of salt, and a tablespoon of sugar. Now mix all the dry ingredients until well combined. And I'm just going to add 2 tablespoons of butter, which is at room temperature. Make sure that your butter is at room temperature. So now mix the butter well with your flour and add 1/4 cup of warm milk. Don't use very hot milk or chilled milk. Use a lukewarm milk. And then I'm just going to add lukewarm water little by little to make into a very soft and loose dough. So the dough which you are making for a bread should have enough moisture in it that helps to form elasticity and gluten in your dough. That way your dough would rise well, so that you will get very soft and fluffy sandwich bread as you get in the store. So make sure that your dough has enough moisture. The best way to know is after you added the water, and your dough should look like a kind of sticky like this. So to avoid the stickiness, you can drizzle little bit of oil. So now I'm just going to knead the dough for 10 minutes. So kneading the dough is very important, as this helps to form gluten in your dough so that it will rise well. So the more your dough rises, the more soft and fluffy bread you are going to get. So the basic thing you have to know is you have to knead the dough for at least 10 minutes. And if you need, you can also add very little bit of dry flour to avoid stickiness. But the main thing is when you knead the dough for 10 minutes, the stickiness would go and your dough will become very soft and smooth like this. So I have kneaded my dough for around 10 minutes, and now you can see it is very soft and it is not sticky at all. So this way you can know that your dough has enough gluten and elasticity in it after you kneaded it. So make sure you are kneading the dough for at least 10 minutes for best sandwich bread. So now I'm just going to press the dough for around 1.5 to 2 hours so that it will rise double in its volume. So transfer it into the mixing bowl, and which is big enough to raise your dough double in its volume. And I am just going to apply little oil over the dough to keep it moisture without drying out. And now cover it with a damp cloth and keep it in a warm place where you used to set your yogurt for a best rise. So I'm just going to place inside my microwave oven and rest it for at least 2 hours. And after 2 hours of resting, now you can see my dough has nicely risen double in its volume. So this is how your dough should look after 2 hours of resting. And now scratch the edges with a knife to shrink it. So So you would obviously see that your dough would become shrink automatically. And now just do this way also. And now I'm going to transfer into my rolling board and make it into a loaf shape. That is the shape which your bread will have. So kind of rectangle shape, you could say. So now I'm just going to take my loaf pan and brush it with some butter. This helps to take out your bread easily once it is done, and also it will not stick to the pan as well. So I'm just going to place my dough inside it, and I'm allowing to rest for another 30 to 40 minutes till it rises double in its volume once again. So cover it with a damp cloth and allow it to rest in the oven for another 30 to 40 minutes. And now you can see it has nicely risen once again double in its volume. So allowing to rest for twice is very important, as this helps to make your bread really soft and fluffy. So I'm just going to apply some milk over the top. That helps to make your bread really golden brown in its color, and also it will not dry out. So now it is ready to go into your oven, which is preheated at 250 degrees Celsius. So bake your bread till the top layer become golden brown in its color. So keep an eye on it when you make it for the first time. So after I baked it for around 18 minutes, my sandwich bread is perfectly done. So the temperature and time may vary depending on the oven. So make sure you are keeping an eye on it when you make it for the first time, and follow that as well. And now you can see the top layer has very nice golden brown color as we get in the store. I'm just going to apply some butter to make the top layer become very soft, and then transfer this hot sandwich bread into a cooling rack to allow it to completely cool down. So it's very hot, so I'm just going to transfer it into my cooling rack and allow this to cool down completely, and then your sandwich bread is ready. So after around 45 minutes, I'm just going to transfer it into a plate, and I will show you guys how the inside goods look like. So it's still slightly warm, so I'm not able to keep on my hand, so just cut it. It's very soft and light actually. So you could see the inner texture also looks same as we get in the stores. This is because of kneading the dough and also rest it for two times till it rises double its volume. So please follow the tips as I mentioned, and try this recipe. And thank you so much for watching my video, and do subscribe for more interesting baking recipes. So see you guys soon. Till then, spice up your taste buds with Deep's Kitchen recipes. Bye bye.